with the light on.
Please don't be offended. We most times we tend to we of the ministers like Elisha. We need the mistral to create the right atmosphere to release. It's like an incubator. There is the right atmosphere that hatches the egg. So we are incubating. Destinies will be hatched this night. I thought on it, people are born again people. I said destinies will be hatched this night. If it looks like your future, you will shout amen like thunder. I worked in Onitsha for 5 years. I worked as a banker before I left it to do what I'm doing. Why I fell in love with Pastor Dan is that he's doing the same thing I'm doing. Any person that has a heart for the young people is the person that has the heart of God. If you catch the young people, you catch the future. In America at the time, the Baptist church and most of these churches were able to impart a generation so much that the devil lost hope in that generation. Went back to sit with the younger children coming up. Sat with them over years, and they were the ones that gave birth to people like Jay-Z, people like Kim Kardashian, and all those people that have turned Hollywood to a crazy land, that have become influencers. Sorry, influencers. That's the right word. They have released disease into a generation. I thank God for the men God is awakening now, because there is hope for the world. Listen, there was something God told me one of the days I was in the mountain. One of the things he was saying is that there was a seed planted in Africa and they went back, but now we are taking back the fruits to them. We are the ones that see seated here are men that will reach out to the global world. I don't know how you're saying, if it looks like you say, I said seated here are men that are going to reach out to the global world. Solution carriers. If it looks like you shot them in like thunder.
Sit down. Kandebo kosivra nande kosivra ate kolazi alaka. Brande kosivra nengo sikalito vale koshivra ande gaya.
I love Onitsha. I'm an Anambra young man. I'm from London. But the thing is that my Igbo is so weary. When I was in Onitsha, I saw the number of young people in Onitsha and my heart panted. So I started a branch of in-gathering in Onitsha, teaching on Sunday in Onitsha, 2 to 4, before 5, I get back to Asaba and teach. And one of the days I was driving down to Onitsha and the Lord told me, I never sent you. You know, the problem with most of us is that nobody sends you. And if God doesn't send you, you pay your transport. When he sent you, lucky anything. If God didn't send you, some people, God only flashed you, you ran. You have not gotten the message. When they tell your neighbor, cool down. Cool down. Cool down. Cool down. Now flash, no be call. And God said, you're not the one. He said, I'm raising a man. I don't know why I'm feeling in my spirit that he might beat Pastor Dan. Because I can feel the spirit. I feel at home. We are rising. We are opening portals on the earth. Passing transactions on the earth. And listen, we are going to function in different spheres of society. There are politicians that will shape the culture of the society. There are education people, people in technology. Oh God, we are rising. Shout them out like thunder. We are rising. Amen. Pastor Ike, stay focused, please. You know, it's the atmosphere of this place is making me misbehave. Amen. I'm already loving this house. I wrote 6 books. One problem we have is that we find it difficult to read and we don't invest in books. I want to just give you this one as a free course. Only loaded men are needed men. Men will only drink from the wells of a wise man. Until you know, you will never be known. Men will sit at your feet to eat from you. Except you have loaded yourself. That's why the greatest investment is the investment in yourself, called self-investment. The greatest asset you have It's not that thing that in between your two legs. It's what is in between your two ears, which is your mind. And until you begin to mind your mind, your world will not mind you. So when you invest in your mind, your world will begin to go. Do you know some of us say, if I give you this microphone, in the next 10 minutes, you're exhausted. And 10 minutes is too much. 5 minutes in, you go kuka tipa. Why? You are not investing in yourself. So please learn to invest. The difference between a poor man and a rich man is knowledge. Rich men invest and they value knowledge. And if you don't value knowledge in this 21st century, my brother, you will run behind. Whether it's in business, if you see what is happening in the world today, you will see the speed at which the world is running. So you must grow in knowledge. Tell your neighbor, grow in knowledge. Now, I wrote a few books. This one is called Secret of Stars. I took time to study stars across 10 spheres of influence. And I was able to extract 10 secrets I saw that was applicable and was universal among the 10 of them, among all of them. Mercy, my Yahweh, oh my Yahweh, oh my Yahweh, my Yahweh, my Yahweh, oh my Yahweh, oh my Yahweh, oh my Yahweh. So I extracted 10 secrets that can help you. When you sit down with them, you see the secrets that has helped them. Ronaldo, Messi, Osombot, just name them. I studied all of them and I saw 10 secrets. And I call it Secret of Stars, Keys to Sustainable Success. And I discovered that every star has a scar. The glory of stars is locked up in their stories. So when you sit down on biographies, you discover what made them get to where they are. We love the glory, but we don't like the paths. It's the cross that brings the glory. So there is a path that they followed. If you discover that path, it is a universal law. You will get to where they got to. One neighbors or Lagos, Igeru, Lagos.
Yes, sir.
So far as you stay on that road, what we do is to discover paths. And this is what men show us. So only wise men ask for paths. This book will help you with that. Number two book I wrote about scaling great heights. I took time to study the ego. And I started 16 principles from what made the ego. That 30 nations looked at the ego and ascribed themselves to be like the ego. I saw 30 nations, including US, Zambia, Nigeria, Dubai. These nations look at the ego and they are so excited. Now, this one, I didn't write this one in the book, but it was because I'm going to rewrite the book. I want to make it 20. Because I've researched for books on egos. I see only 7. I took my time to do 16, but I'm working on 20. I discovered that the ego is a mathematician. Now, do you know that if an ego wants to pick a prey in front of a car, the ego sits in the air and draws a Pythagoras theory. Calculates the speed of the car before it gets to the prey. Calculates the speed it needs to add to get to the prey before the car comes. And it will pick it and go. And including the extra speed the man will add, I will move. That's why when you see it will move, it will pick it and go. And say, look at this one. The ego is a mathematician. Do you know that the ego is a divine bird, a covenant bird? It's the only bird God ascribed himself to. It's the king of the air. Flies above 10,000 feet above sea level. The only bird the plane sees is the eagle. The only bird. Do you know, no matter what happens, the eagle will never eat dead meat. No matter how hungry the eagle is. And the eagle stays with one mate till death. The eagle takes time to shed off itself. It breaks its beak. First of all, it uses its beak to take away its feathers, because at that time the feathers can no more lock. Because when the eagle wants to soar, it does not fly, it soars. The eagle rides the wind like you ride a horse. When you're riding the horse supplies the strength, not the rider. So he sits, that's why we fly on the wings of Emmanuel.
Hallelujah.
That's called the wind of the Spirit. So he sits on, when he wants to move to a place, he sits down, listens to the sound, and knows where the air is going to. Then he flies and sits on the air and begins to move. But he first locks his wing. He becomes airtight. But there's a time that comes, I think when the eagle is about 40, at that time the wings cannot lock. It's no more tight. At that time, his beak has bent. He can't hear it. His talons are weak. They can't hear. So he has to go through a painful process. He relocates to the mountain. Sees that the mountain uses his beak and tear all his feather. He will be naked and grow back his feather. We take his talon, scratch it until it breaks. And when it breaks, we allow it to go. Then you take his beak and break it. And he now waits, drinking water for 5 months. When he comes out, he's renewed to live for another 30 years. Do you know that eagle lives up to 70 years? There are many more inside there. Holy fire, holy fire, holy fire, holy fire, born of nation you can live in beyond this nation that affects every other nation is called imagination.
Yeah.
Dream is something you do for free. A GV is a gathered nation. You don't need a plane. You can sit down with your mind and create the pictures of the future that you can capture through scriptures, future in it, and not be ruptured in life. Power of dreams, types of dreams. Who do you need to fulfill your dream? Who do you need to run away from? If not, they'll destroy your dreams. Sir, the first time God spoke to me to start in garden, I sat with 7 pastors. 7 pastors! They told me it's impossible. Be careful who you share your dream. Do you know many dreams don't see the daylight? That dream could have died that day. They told me how it was impossible. Pastors! I didn't say pastors. When we did the first conference, none of them came. But when they now see our conferences that see 3,000, 4,000, they hide in shame. Those that mock you, we be the ones to be shamed. I'm telling you, see, my brother, the only revenge you have is be successful. The only revenge you owe people is just be successful. Just be successful. They didn't believe in you, just be successful. Don't. I was teaching my people never to give up. I said, if the only gift you have is persistence, you will never fail. Don't get bulldog tenacity, unbendable will, unstoppable. This book will help you in that. Attributes of future leaders. It has to do with leaders. Man of God, I sat down, the Spirit of God says, teaching me from Genesis chapter 1 verse 1. In the beginning, God, every leader starts alone. In the beginning, you're the only one that believes in your vision. If you're waiting to get validation from men, you will never run any vision. You are the best and the first believer of your vision. The investor of your vision. You will run your vision alone. And God called Abraham alone. Alone. He was telling me how he started in his room. That's how I started. I started in my parlor. You will so much believe in your vision that it is realer than your hand. From Genesis, I began to see leaders are solution providers. They confront challenges. I wrote about 10, 12 of them there. Let me go into my teaching first. Then this one, achieve greatness. Hey, if Fridays are your best days and Mondays your worst days, you're not in your purpose. Your purpose every day is thank God it's Friday.
My brother, there is a reason. There is what is called satisfaction and fulfillment. You don't see, let me tell you, you are so opportune that God brought Pastor Dan to your life to open you up to certain things we are not open to when we were your age. If I knew some of the things I'm teaching my people then, what now we're 11 be sitting up by now? At 17, 16, 18, 19, you're hearing this. There is no way you can fail. You're not shouting amen. There is no, even if devil has you, even if you don't want to fail, you don't want to succeed, it is late. Hey. You can't be under this kind of grace and fail in life. I thought I'll hear an amen like thunder. Yeah. You can't. Under this kind of grace, no, you can't fail. In this book, there are 4 things I thought about. How to discover your purpose. How to discover your gift. Every man came loaded. No man came empty. Every man came because there was a problem that was seen to be solved. How to understand your timing and how to build your character. All in this book. Then this one is what I'm going to be teaching today. Unmasking sex. Keys to satisfy sexuality. This brings me to my topic today. Addiction free. Let's sit down. I'll be teaching. I'll be singing. Please blend with me. If you're not used to it, forgive me.
They are hungry to drink this bowl of fire. These ones are hungry. These ones are thirsty. They are hungry.
A bad word. What matters is what are you addicted to? Because addiction has made many people great. Or some boat was addicted to running and he became the fastest man on earth. Michael Epps was addicted to swimming, that spent 18 hours in the water. 18 hours in water. He became the living Olympian with over 22 gold medals. Michael Jackson danced for 18, he dances for 18 hours in a studio. He invented moonwalk. You know moonwalk? He invented moonwalk. You can't be a star until you become an addict. What is his name? Bill Gates was addicted to solving challenges and creating softwares that can help a computing machine called computer. Being which somebody had prophesied and said, this thing will be a toy that will fizzle out in the next few years. But he was addicted to creating softwares that can make the computer very helpful to humanity and be in every home in the world, and he became the richest man on earth. He was not pursuing money, he was pursuing his addiction. A man sat in his house and thought, how can I connect the world to a platform whereby they can sell and buy and be able to get the product, and it's called Amazon. That made him the richest man on earth. So addiction is not the bad thing. What matters is what are you addicted to. Addiction has 2 possibilities locked up in it. One is that addiction can be for your destruction or for your construction. There is what we call good addictions and bad addictions. They write this thing that I'm going to teach, and I'm going to trust God, because the deliverance that will take off this night, Pastor Don is the one that will carry it out. I trust God. God, deliverance is going to take place this evening. Now, good addictions will make you. Bad addictions will mar you. Good addictions will help you. Bad addiction will hurt or harm you. Good addictions will raise you. Bad addictions will ruin you. Good addictions will build you. Bad addictions will break you. So, every man on earth is an addict. You are here and where you are today by reason of your addictions. So, your addictions becomes your progression or becomes your stagnation, with retrogression, meaning your life falling apart. Please,
You know one thing about Igbos, our challenge is that we too like that thing that will make us to be shouting and shouting. We find it difficult to sit down to learn. Jesus went around teaching and preaching. Teaching is what gets you rooted and grounded, so that you not be pushed by every wind of doctrine. It's when you're grounded to, he said, the word I speak to you, their spirit and their life. He said, you're clean by the word I speak unto you. He said, the entrance of his word giveth light and giveth understanding to the simple. So when teachings are coming, my brother, open your ears, open your heart. Because you do, he said, until his word came, his word tried him. He said, I commend you to God and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up and give you an inheritance. See, there is a courier, carrier, and conveyor of God's solution. It's called his word. For he has exalted his word above all his things. So if you don't know how to celebrate God's word, you don't know how to celebrate God. For in the beginning was God, and God was his word. So God can't do anything without his word. Even his word had to become flesh and stand amongst men. We beheld his glory, full of grace. Even Jesus is called the word of God. So when the word is being taught, the greatest thing they do, you see that parable Jesus was teaching is what is happening here. When the word is coming, the best are waiting to steal. That word that can change your life. Every great man had a word. He spoke a word to Jacob, it enlightened Israel. Every great man is carrying a word. Because the word you carry is the solution to the earth. So if you don't have what you're carrying, you have nothing to offer. So you don't know. In teachings like this, in meetings like this, do you know it was in a meeting that Dangote caught the idea to start production? He was an importer. It was in a meeting, an observation, that he caught an insight that made him to go into production and has made him the richest man in Africa. Let me tell you, those things are peanuts. Greater kingdom financiers are rising in this house. Men that will shut the mouth of Babylon. See, Apostle Simon said something. He said, without Joseph Alamantia, the body will decay on the cross.
Ah.
We need Joseph of Alamantia.
Hey.
Men that can speak with power. So if you have a doctrination of poverty, sorry, you're in the wrong place. You came for healing. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 19. NLT, I want to show you something. He says, today I have given you the choice between life and death, between blessings and curse. Now I call on heaven and earth to witness the choice you make. Oh, that you would choose life so that you and your descendants will live. My brother, your choices becomes your addiction. See, your addiction can either be a blessing to you or become a curse. Can either give you life or bring death. And can also make you a life giver or a death carrier. That wherever you come, you bring death. There are people that wherever they go, they bring death. Your addiction can make you a blessing to a generation or a curse. Some of us seated here, if we look at our grandfathers, and you get offended because it's as if they were a curse. When you hear somebody like Bishop Oyedepo, what do you think his grandchildren will call him? You will be a blessing to your generation. A good man liveth for his children. A good inheritance. Good inheritance. Whatever you are addicted to controls you. Whatever you are addicted to rules you. Whatever you are addicted to enslaves you. And whatever you are addicted to becomes your master. So check that addiction. Is it worthy of you calling it your master? What is addiction? Addiction is a state of being enslaved to a habit or a practice. I served a man called Pastor Jalat for 2 years. I finished his service in 2006. I was expecting to get a job because God had told me I work in the bank. But the Lord sent me to him to be built, raised, and trained by him. Because only trained men reign in life. If you're not trained, you will not be traced. Let me tell you, the difference between a police and army is training. Training. I sat on without salary. Some of you that are serving him, don't be expecting 1 naira.
There is something called true riches. It's greater than money. That's what drops on men that serve great men of God. True riches. I served the man, something dropped after 2 years. You know, that was what Elijah gave Elisha. It's intangible, unseeable, but undeniable. You can't deny. It's great. I came into Asaba with a bag. I didn't know anybody. But Lord, you need to see the lives. And we don't want to exaggerate. No less than 30,000 to 50,000 young people in the past 7-8 years. I kept wondering. I could have still been at the back of the computer chopping 300,000, traveling with my wife around the world, and destinies would be wasted. That's why the Bible says when he opened the book and many other books were opened. Until certain books are open, many other books will not be open. Some of you need to rise, because there are people who their destiny is tied to you. And until you arise, see, if Gideon doesn't rise, Israel will die. If Joseph doesn't rise, Israel will die of famine. Rehabunking in the past 10 years has won 72 million souls only in Africa. 72 million souls in Africa. What about if Rehabunking was smoking? Nagimi, hero, Ompa, Wetrem Ompa, you're wasting time. I was telling my people, Jesus, eternity is forever and ever and ever. We are practicing eternity now. Whatever you're doing now, you're preparing yourself for where you will stay. You find it difficult to stay in the house of God, but you want to stay with God in heaven. It's a lie. You find it difficult to pray. You find it difficult to stay in his word, but yet you want to stay with him. No, you have made your choice on earth. You like clubbing. You will stay with your father when you get there.
Hey.
How can you like clubbing and want to stay in heaven? It's not possible. For I will be singing and dancing and jumping and shouting for the rest of eternity. My daddy,
my daddy.
Your homeboy is singing,
baby is singing.
I will be singing and dancing and shouting for the rest of the eternity. To the end, only you.
To the end, only you.
Only you, only you.
To the sea, only you.
Only you.
My daddy, my daddy,
your baby is singing,
baby is singing.
Hey!
I will be singing
and shouting for the rest of eternity. Hey! Chineke,
Chineke,
your baby is singing,
baby is singing.
I will be singing and dancing
and shouting for the rest of eternity.
Araga Wekwensu. The devil will regret your destiny.
Only you.
Hey, sit down. One day, if you're not the born again, you're not the guy, man. Guy, men are found in the house of God. Do you know what is guy, man? God's unique youth. G-U-Y. God's unique youth. But listen, if they say you're a Jew, no problem. Jesus is a Jew. So whether Jew or guy, we there. Sit down. Chineke. Addition is a state. We'll be teaching and enjoying. This is called, in his presence there is fullness of joy. There is pleasures evermore.
Only you are.
To the end, only you.
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 Only you, only you.
Only you.
Only you are God. Tell your neighbor, it's a gift. One day you go to one cup, come on, call the high.
That's how we drink. That's how we drink. A drunkard, there is nothing impossible. Nothing stops a drunkard. He's not afraid of anything. Drunkards are rising this night. It's called burning wine. Burning wine. Have you drank this burning wine? Some people in their club. This is our club.
I will be singing and singing just for the rest of the day.
Sit down. Sit down. Somebody chatted me on Facebook, one of my uncles, and said, the kind of joy and smile I see in your face, I know you have touched something, I need it. See, be so joyful. All the addictive. It is feverishous. It is contagious. You can't come to handling. And he again, first again. It's Ebola. Thank you, Jesus. Addition is. It happens once in a while when you hold the meter and the Holy Ghost takes over. Even the preacher is also slain. You know, when the Holy Ghost decides to sit as the refiner's fire and the purifier of the sons of Levites, that they may offer unto him a sacrifice of righteousness. Hey. You see, this place will explode, though. Fourth dimension is about to explode. Onitsha is about to hear the voice of this vision. It's about to explode. I can feel it. It's about to explode. It's about to explode. Guys, hang on with this man. This man is carrying something. He knows where he's going. Hang on to this man. Hang on to this man. Hang on to this man. I hope I'm blessing you. Okay. Addiction is a state of being enslaved to a habit or a practice. Something that is psychologically or physically habit forming to such an extent that each cessation causes severe trauma. Now, when somebody gets addicted, it becomes difficult to stop it. See, youthful time is a time of investment. It's a sowing time. You're sitting here. This year, 4 months ago, I have not read one book. That's why you cannot be booked in life. Pornography has a vision. And what's the vision? It's destruction of your destiny and your marriage. The target of pornography, masturbation, is your marriage. Let me tell you. Family is one of God's greatest mystery. The most powerful organization on the earth. More powerful than Coca-Cola. More powerful than Amazon. More powerful than Facebook. Do you know why? Without families, there will be no inventor of those things. So every inventor came from a family. Family are the molding block of the society. So it is the foundation. And if the foundation be destroyed, what will the righteous do? If the foundation of this building is bad, we cannot stay here. All these things will be a waste. Families form the society. Society forms the nation. Nation forms continent. Continent forms the world. The devil being a wise serpent. The devil, you can call him a real nothing, but once you can't call him, he's a fool. He's not a fool. He has been in this world over 6,000 years. Here I am, in your presence. Do to me what you want. I'm open before you, God. Do to me what you
This is the place of encounter. Do to me what you want. This is the place where my life is changed. Do to me what you want.
Pornography is any printed or visual material containing explicit display of sexual organs, activities that induce stimulation for sexual satisfaction. Anything you see that shows nudity and stirs up your desire towards immorality is pornography. Let me shock you with, because this I'm going to be talking, many of them are here, because I can't touch everything. I was, the topic game was too big. I'm not going to be talking about sexual immorality. I talked about it here. Masturbation, I talked about it here. I talked about incense, homosexuality, all of them here. But I want to get you to the root cause. Now, over $20 billion is spent annually on pornography. Pornography is a big business. Sex is a big business. It's one of the strongest urges on earth. There is the urge for money. Passion for wanting to make money. There is a passion for food. Passion for water. Passion for greatness. And there is passion for sex. And this one, everyone carries it except eunuchs. Any man that can't control his sexuality, he will lose his destiny. My brothers and sisters, let erection don't give you direction. The destiny, every Joseph will have a Potiphar's wife positioned to stop him from getting to the palace. There is always a Potiphar's wife positioned to stop you from the palace. Do you know my joy for Joseph? He didn't see a servant chair. He saw a throne. So when she was saying, I will make you the head of servants, he said, no, my destiny is not a chair, it's a throne. And listen, what makes a throne is not the size of the chair, it's just that the king sat on it. The presence of a king makes a throne. If you like, let it be a stone. If he sits on it, it's a throne. Masturbation is touching one's body, sexual organ, for sexual pleasure. For the male, they touch their penis. For the woman, they play with the clitoris of their vagina. I thought I'm going to be saying something. Lies about masturbation is that masturbation is a way of ibapukonji, sexual pressure. Let me tell you, because of us born again Christians, and as a sound minister maybe here, you have a reputation to protect. The sister you want to talk to, you say, pastor, brother, prayer warrior. So because of it, when the congenus comes and you don't know how to control it, there is no woman or lady anywhere to package it for you. You now opt to a private business called masturbation, because it is a private matter. Nobody will know. And you use it. So many people will be even masturbate. I will be teaching. People will not even know what they have been doing. Only to find that through teaching. Killer the cuckoo paradise.
Let there be light.
that you see anointed brothers jump seeking tongues, but they have a private devil. It terrorizes them. I went to a minister after preaching, the whole choir came out. Even the pastor had to come. He said, "One, I was supposed to come out, but you know I'm the pastor." He has no respect for age. He has no respect. Private demon that destroys destinies. It is suicide in small doses. Suicide. To be carnally minded is death. So he can keep, you see, let me tell you, you have a younger brother, a younger sister. Very well in JS class. First, second, very intelligent. But now, Omo, you can't understand what's happening to him. Obagancha. 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 Because there is a connection between sexuality and mentality. I'll talk about it. There is something about here that does something here. Sexuality and mentality. The devil knows what he's doing. So what causes it? You know, some people say, because of us, so they don't want to have STDs or impregnate people, so they masturbate. Let me shock you. Every research is sponsored. So, you know the problem with us? We don't research in Africa. You know, it might take somebody 40 years to get one result in a research. Onyibu gaju, egole. It's a 40 years. Name again. Nam na research ozo akokoko again. One number one. Oga kuru mubondi. Ahumpala regene. It's a combination of read and search. Research. But it also goes into practicals. So if they want you to believe anything, they can research and give it to you. If they want it, they have been there. I don't want to go into that. There are conferences we go in Benin. They'll be teaching us some things that the researchers they bring out in a way to silence Africa. See, if Africa wakes up, every other continent will become slaves to us. 70% of raw materials in the world is here. We are the ones feeding the world. Corruption is a good thing to America. If not, they can stop it. If you bring money, they ask you, I work in the bank. They don't ask them. They'll come out and say, we're working, fighting corruption. You know, it's not corruption, it's corruption. 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 I didn't say anything. We can't stop it. God told me that the hour for Africa has come. My brother, be preparing. There is a day of light. There is. Nobody's seeing now. You're killing your beer and your lion.